Hello.
My name is Dana, for those who do not know. I'm a liberation coach and spiritual and emotional intuitive guidance. Hi, hello. I'm just getting started. And I'm going to clear the energy here just a little bit of the Tibetan thingy wall. I believe this one resonates with the heart chakra. I usually feel it pretty strongly in the heart. It's important with the type of music you listen to and the types of sound that you allow yourself to be around and to listen to, because sound, like music and stuff, even the way people speak and at what tone, has a shape and it has an effect. There's cause and effect. Circles right now, but it feels like a nice, almost like a ripple. Like this to me feels like you see some murky water in a pond, and then you throw something in it like a pebble, and it feels like the ripples look whenever they travel, just clearing away all that muck that's on the surface of the pond. That's how this feels to me. That I'm very in tune and tapped in with my senses. very self-aware. And so you might not feel the same thing, but that's okay. Just breathe. If you're listening right now in the replay, just breathe and be aware of your what you're sensing. And if you feel any sort of heaviness or sensations around certain areas of your body, then that's telling you there's a heaviness there. And if there's a heaviness at your throat, that means you need to speak your truth. Or someone doesn't want you to speak your truth. I'm just going to continue this a little longer than normal because I do feel a heaviness pretty strongly. The heaviness in certain areas, sometimes I come to a realization that it's not just me feeling that in certain areas. I feel as if there may be some sort of like collective quieting. I'm not sure what it is, but something trying to hold us back from speaking what we need to speak in order for us all to rise. I feel it lifting out from my throat right now. I feel it at my jaw now. I'm doing this a little longer than normal. Just breathe and notice where you feel any heaviness or if you feel something lifting up and away from you as you listen. It could even just be my voice and this together. And the realization, noticing the heaviness. Sometimes that's all it needs. Awareness. There are actually sound healers and sound therapists now, which is amazing. It's amazing that it's come up like that in this world, to be known of the beauty and the magic and the healing properties of music. There are many types of healing modalities now available, and music and sound is one of the easiest ones. It's something you don't need surgery for, you don't need a doctor for, you just have to understand and realize what feels good and what doesn't. This feels fantastic to me. It almost feels as if something's lifting away from my face. The right side of my face. It's not easy to be this self-aware in a world like this. But we can make it easier. Just a couple more seconds of this and then I'll get started on a general message. whoever's here, if you want to comment your name, so if you want like a personal message or if you could just follow along, that's great. I will be posting the replay. I'm going to do some zodiac ones too. Another good way to clear your energy is get outside and also moving your body, drinking water, which I need to do more of, swimming in the ocean is very, very good. Yeah. All right. Alright, that was a lot longer than usual, but my throat feels clear now. Alright, hello. Hi, guys. What's up? I'm gonna get started with a general message here, and then I'm gonna go through the zodiac. I will be posting a replay on my YouTube. It is, my name is Mega444. Or I believe it's, yeah, it's my name is Mega442. 444 as well. Just like this. The link is on in my bio. If there's anything, any requests that you would like for me to carry through, just let me know. I do have an OnlyFans that is, there's no pornography, it's more for liberation, but there is nudity. It is onlyfans.com/mega444, M-E-G-A. Okay, so if you have a request for a zodiac energy, a zodiac sign, what people say, or something personal for you, just please let me know. I do the zodiacs because I'm able to tap in more easily into those particular energies, okay? So I did that part. Let's see here. I also have, for you guys and for those who watch the replay, I also have a notepad here for like requests for positive affirmations or aka like prayers, okay, for you guys. So if you have anything that you would like for me to speak out for you, or just anything at all that you need help with bringing about in your life or in your heart or in your mind or anything like that, just let me know and I'll put you on the list. That goes for those who watch the replay as well, okay? All right. Okay, I'm gonna start with a general message. This is for everyone, collective. So what's gonna happen is it's gonna, what I usually am guided to kind of vibrationally to speak is like the most prominent thing that most of the collective is going through right now. Something that brings clarity. May we all get clarity and receive peace and clarity in this moment. And progressively forward, may we all have the opportunity to live a healthy, successful, and vibrant life freely. Yes. And may we all be liberated from that which holds us back, too, or down. The thing with liberation is it's coming out of fear, protected by angels, who are cherished by the angels. So I feel like maybe collectively a lot of us are getting a touch, starting to touch on really getting along with ourselves, and maybe a touch of like experiencing a little bit of like loneliness and stuff like that, or feeling like we've been left in the dust or left behind, okay? You are not left behind, you're not forgotten. Even if it feels like or seems like no one's there or no one notices you, you are noticed, you are cherished. And even if it doesn't seem like that, you are cherished. And this isn't, if you feel that way, then this is an opportunity for you to be there for yourself and to know that you have it in you to do anything. And you don't need anyone at all with you to do anything or to feel loved. You can give that love to yourself, okay? Something about relationships. Maybe unity or something. Something about unionizing. Something about unity. Okay. Okay, so a narrow pathway. Okay, so I'm seeing, like, imagine that you, okay. Narrow pathway. Actually, I don't usually do this, but I'm gonna get the book for a second because I'm seeing all kinds of different messages for that, different metaphors and things like that. But I think that this is, when your path becomes narrow, success will ensue if you go slowly and carefully. The traveler takes one step at a time, deliberately and cautiously. No detail of the path is overlooked. Keep your focus on the steps ahead. Do not get ahead of yourself. Breathe, relax. You will be able to achieve what others have not if you take the time to carefully consider all options and move forward with deliberate care. Okay. So, it seems as if, yeah, this is about not getting lost in the details or not rushing through and paying attention, like dotting your I's and crossing your T's. And stuff, and if you're like me and you like to go with the flow and just let things happen the way they do, then people like us, like, we're fine with like detours and trying different things. We're about experiences and stuff like that. But if you're actually setting out on a new thing or on a path that you want to try and it's important to you, then it's important to make sure that all of your paperwork, make sure you're double checking your paperwork, you're doing things step by step. See, like me, I have a hard time sometimes with like the smaller steps. Like, I just see the bigger picture and I see the really big picture, like all of it as a whole, which can be a good thing because my mind is open, right? But it's important, you can't just get from A to B. There's all kinds of little bitty tiny steps and all that. So this has to do with like planning. Okay, so if you you can start putting in your calendar, like I started doing too, like put in your calendar the things that, like the steps, like create a list of things to do as far as what's going to get you there and what isn't, and just know yourself. You got to know yourself really well to know your, like, your weaknesses and your strength and stuff, and the things that make you kind of be held back, you know, that's overcoming those things too, because a narrow pathway is about Maybe, okay, so like a narrow pathway, it might feel alone. It might feel lonely, like you're treading your own way, but it doesn't mean that you're alone. It's just that, like you're the only one that's fitting in there right now. And that's so that you can know yourself better and to like know your, you know where you're going and be sure of where you're going. Cause there isn't anybody else cluttering up your path, like beside you, to tell you where you need to go and to tell you where you're going, because no one's gonna know like you do. Not really. It's okay to ask people for advice and stuff. It's okay to get their opinion so that you can consider them, because other perspectives are healthy and actually good. However, no one's gonna know your exact path like you. Like, that's like deep in your core. No one can take that from you. No one can tell you what that is at all. Even if they went through a certain thing, a similar thing, even if they went down a similar path, no one is like you. Nobody's like you. There are many narrow paths. There's only not only one narrow path. There's a lot of them. And just because this one was narrow doesn't mean that yours isn't. If that makes sense. Okay, that's for somebody. That was for me too, actually. Okay. Okay, yeah, so let's see. Also, the rainbow is speaking to me. I like to do, so, like, okay, I don't know if a lot of people realize, it was for you too, awesome. I don't know if a lot of people realize this, but, like, you know, the archangels and stuff, what people call upon them and things like that, those are the rays to me. They're the, like, colors, okay? And if any of you are deeply connected to that, I am very much so. Always have been. And so, we got, this card came out, Rainbow Blessings, okay? So whenever I do, like sometimes whenever I do like centering and things like that, sometimes I like to visualize like the rainbow light like coming down and flushing through me from every direction. And I like to do that because if it's almost like a rainbow wash of the color. And okay, so I don't know why I'm saying that, but maybe you can use that. So, but I love it. It makes me feel more clear and energized. Okay, you can do it for your mind too. You can do it for your mind too if you're having a problem with like a cluttered mind or thoughts and things like that, or if you've been consuming things that weren't necessarily healthy for your well-being, then you can do the rainbow visualization. If you have any questions about that, just let me know. You can DM me. I'm trying to get back on track here. I've been doing this for about a week again. I used to be on here for a couple years ago, but I'm back, and I've always separated the colors. I think the rainbow concept is awesome. So I started doing that, and I really like it because it's like the entire rainbow just like kind of washing through. I actually got that from someone else like last year or the year before, and she received that, like it was imparted to her from her higher guidance or our higher guidance, and it was for the mind. So I just started using that in my visualization when I'm trying to center and just get everything clear. And then it wasn't from like my mind didn't tell me to do it. It was just kind of like I knew it would help. So I think, you know, it's a great way to like raise your frequency and stuff too if you're really like focused and committed to doing that. Okay, so maybe you can do that. Okay. So, do you by chance have a lot of Gemini in your energy? Okay, it's either that or it's just because I need to start with Gemini today. I do feel that a lot. I don't know, I might have felt Gemini energy before last time first, I don't know why. But I wasn't seeing if it was for you. Okay, the number three, okay, Gemini is where my North Node is, and also my Chiron is Gemini. I am Lance, and I changed my username. I am Mercury dominant in my chart, if that helps. You are? Are you a speaker? Do you do things like this? Mercury dominant? So am I. Well, Mercury is very... I'm very connected to Mercury. This is for Gemini. Gemini, I like to voice my truth. That's so funny. Did you miss the beginning whenever I was clearing energy? Because I was feeling a lot of heaviness in my throat. And so I did the Tibetan singing bowl. I did the sound healing a little bit longer than usual because I wanted to feel the sensation of that lifting from my throat. And actually did. Like, I literally, like, felt it, like, lifting up. So usually if you feel like a heaviness or some sort of a kind of feels like a blockage or something, like around your throat, that's because you need to speak your truth or because someone doesn't want you to. Speak your truth. You do? Okay. So you can sing or like a gargle. You already know that stuff, right? Do you already know how to clear your throat? You can sing. Sorry, I just thought of something. Like, I'm not saying it out loud, but okay. So it's funny because duality came out. Okay, so I have. I know there are a lot of ways. Liberation, okay? Alright, so duality. Duality's been coming out a lot because we as a collective, I believe, are like pushing through the illusion of duality. You do? Always bring a smile and a laugh out of you. I love it. Yeah, good. You didn't even DM me. What the hell? Alright, so this is for Gemini, which is crazy because I actually have a Sagittarius sun, and well, I like almost all my planets were in Sagittarius when I was born. And this is Gemini is like the opposite opposite spectrum of Sagittarius. You did? I didn't see it. Okay, I have to change the song because it's taking me somewhere else. Hold on. Hey. So we got duality. Hey, Tessa. So listen, it's a black bird and a white bird. Okay, so this is what I see with this picture, okay? So here's a branch, right? And the white bird and the... It's number 26. So it's a white bird and a black bird. And they're completely opposite colors. They're just opposite colors, though. It doesn't mean they're opposite. You know? It might look opposite, but it's not really opposite. There is a commonality there. They're both birds. And they're looking at this branch. And you know that saying, make like a tree and leave? Right? So it's like they're looking up at it like, I'm not leaving. Are you leaving? No. I'm not leaving. Are you leaving? No. Okay, well then we need a compromise here. Because I'm not leaving to that. We're just gonna stand here. And we're just gonna look at each other like, I thought you were so different from me, but you're actually not. Let's have a conversation. What is it that makes us seem so opposite? And like we can't get along? Why did we think we couldn't get along? I don't know. Was it because we seem so different? Or because someone said that we were dual? Are we really dual? Or are we actually a lot alike? It's like they're having that conversation. I don't know, I just saw that like playing out. So it's like that sometimes whenever you meet someone or if you actually are going through a polarity type of thing, a lot of times it's not even as like polar as it seems. Because over time, you know, like over time, polarities tend to balance out more and more. Okay, so we're like times like this, it's not even polar anymore. It's like we're just kind of clearing away the rest of the differences. And a lot of the differences have to do with like beliefs and like things that are not even, it's like the illusions. You know what I mean? That's what I got from that. Hi guys, for the ones who joined, I am the illusion of separation, exactly. And yes, I love that. And so I say that a lot. I talk about that a lot because the illusion of separation, that's exactly what it is. We're not even like really separate. I see it as like, you know, I don't believe that ego is like necessarily a bad thing, because to me, I see ego as like, it's been a very useful tool in this journey of remembering oneness and wholeness. And I say remembering because it's a journey of remembrance during an illusion of separation, and that's a challenge. To me, that's the challenge, is realizing that we're not actually separate. And when you realize that, then you won't ever really feel alone, because you'll know that we're not. You know what I mean? AK. It's another one. Perception. Obviously, okay. Obviously, that's something that's a big theme. Okay, so 269, okay, Venus and Taurus. Okay, you might have a Venus and Taurus or something like that, okay? If you're watching the replay, okay? We are light and dark, feminine and masculine, one is all and all is one. That's exactly right. But a lot of people don't understand that, or they don't, like, they haven't been educated on that. You know? Like, if we were all light and completely light, then we wouldn't be able to be here on Earth, because this is really right now at this time, I don't believe. Okay, so this is yin yang symbol and sign, okay? And like, I like to see, like, sometimes I say, you know, I'm the line in the middle of that, and it's like they're so that's both of those is like that, okay? So, oh my gosh, so yeah, this is totally about opposites. And it's not about opposites attract, it's about coming together and realizing that we're not actually opposite at all. We're complementary. Okay, you can have clash or complementary. And to be enable, in order to be complementary, it takes realizing commonalities and like a common thread per se. Or like, how can we mesh and blend so that we're not repelling one another? And that could be within you too. Like, that doesn't mean just two people. It can mean inside of you or within you or within somebody else, because it doesn't have to clash. Whenever you start realizing like commonalities, you have to be somewhat of a like a peacemaker a little bit in order to come into this balance or this wholeness, because that's what it's about. It's about balance and recognizing a different or finding a different perspective. Because something that seems so opposite and so different, it's not that different really. It's about your vision and about the taking the lens off of judging, of judgment. If you have the lens of judgment on you, you're always going to see it as something that is nothing like you, that is nothing like the other. But if you can open your eyes and see that it's all the same, and like if you see that, if you believe that it comes from the same pool, then it's not meant to be repelled or polarized. It's there to complement one another, to become whole, and that's the magical. That's whenever it gets really magical. You see? Because like I said, that they're not just opposite because of their color. They're both birds. And this right here is not opposite. They're both a part of a circle. Right? Mm-hmm. I'm just gonna do one more for Gemini here. Actually, that was more of a collective thing, but I feel like there is some Gemini. Okay, if you're still watching and you're a Gemini, and you're interested, you could be Gemini, Sun, Moon, anything, a planet at all, or energy. Because, there's a lot more than just your Sun that goes into it. And if you're interested in a birth chart analysis, just send me $20 in a DM, and I will send you a link to a private YouTube video for you. Okay? Okay, Gemini. Gemini is an energy. It's not a person, place, or thing. It is literally an energy that we draw upon. It's an air energy. I believe that now, in this time of evolution, it's more than just air now. I do believe that. I feel that very much so. Because we are coming together in wholeness and oneness. I believe we take things and not just take things, but we gain things from the other, and it turns into something stronger and more potent. I believe long ago it maybe was just air, but I don't believe that it's just an air energy anymore. I'll get into that another day, actually. Okay, okay, Gemini, you might be holding something in, as far as, what to do or what you should be doing. You might be stuck on some sort of, way of doing things, and you're not, and you're not really listening to your inner self. You may be stuck in a time or a thing that the same way you've always done things. It's like you're doing something that's the same exact way, but it's not really working anymore. Like, it's not serving you anymore. Okay, like, you, it's like an old habit or an old routine that's kind of dried up now, and it's not benefiting you at all. And sometimes it can start to feel like a dread when you start to do it. It can feel like a deep, it says, what's the niggling feeling telling you? What's the niggling? Trust the niggle. Okay? So you might have a niggle to change something in your life or in the way you do things, but you're maybe afraid of what will happen or if you can do it or not. Okay? So it has to, that's what this has to do with, is like doing things the same exact way or believing the same exact thing that is getting stale. And when you believe the same exact thing and you're doing the same thing that's getting stale, it keeps you in a loop. It gets you in a loop of unfulfillment. And what happens is, like, you stay in this loop and so much that it can even, like, hypnotize you into stay into that loop because you're so used to it. It's just like a momentum thing. But what you have to do is you have to step off the track. You got to step off that treadmill, you know, and really get in touch with, okay, why am I not doing something different? Is there a different way this can be done? Is there something that resonates better with my vibration and frequency or my growth now? That I can do. Why am I afraid to do that? You got to step off the treadmill, step off the loop to change it. Because until you step off the loop, you're gonna stay in that same stale crap, you know. And if you step off of it, then it can help you rise up and actually get in touch and resonate better with what you're doing. But sometimes it has to do with your mindset too. If you have a mindset and ideas or perspective that tells you that there's only one way to do things or this is the only way that works, then that's up to you to let go of that and to believe and trust in yourself that you're doing the right thing whenever you change it or change something about it, because it you do deserve to do things a different way that brings you fulfillment and happiness, okay? Break the chain. Yeah, so sometimes, like, staying in the same, like, loop or the same routine and becoming stale in it, like, without trusting the call or the urge to change something, then, like, that's what you're keeping yourself in chains. That's what you're doing. Like, you're keeping yourself in a cage. You're keeping yourself held back from the higher purpose or your higher timeline that you can have by doing that. Like, you're keeping yourself there. Okay, it says break the chain, ancestral patterns, healing, rewriting the future. Yeah, because it's like one of those things where it's like, okay, look at my life right now. Is this how I want it to be in 5 years from now? Is this how I want it to be in 10 years? If the answer is no, what do I need to change about it? And why am I not doing that? Or why haven't I done that? You know, have I been keeping myself in chains because I think this is the only way to do it? Do I believe this is the only way to do this? And why? Did someone tell me that? You know what I mean? So, no, it's not It's not the only way, and it's, you know, you gotta break the chains. So whoever you are, may you feel free to break the chains and to release yourself from whatever entrapment or cage that you're in right now. May you have a healed mindset and new perspective about yourself, about your life, and about the past. May you be able to let go of the past stories that you've replayed over and over in your mind. You know, the more that you think about things, memories and remember stuff, do you know that your mind, your brain can change them every time? And then the more you think about it and dwell on it, it can change them. And you know, like, you might not remember it the same anymore. Like, our brain can do that because it's almost like we're recreating a story in the way that we feel like it happened. And that's not healthy. And that's one of the reasons why it's not healthy to dwell in past experiences and memories. So may you be able to let go of those things so that you can move forward freely and release yourself from that cage and step off that treadmill or that loop that you've had yourself in, and release the old beliefs and opinions that others have had about what you should be doing and what the right way is, because you deserve it. May you be able to view your future and have a positive foresight that does lead you onto your highest timeline and your most fulfilling life. May you have that. May you do that so that you can have the most rewarding life that you've had ever. Okay, so that's where Gemini energy resonates with you. Awesome. Okay. Good. I'm glad. Okay. All right. So we just Gemini. I hope that resonated with someone else who watched to you in the replay. Let me know if you have any questions or anything else at all. Let's see here. So we did Gemini. Alright, we're gonna do Capricorn. Capricorn. Let's see here. Okay, I'm filling these for Capricorn. So this has to do with, this is Capricorn energy. You can have Capricorn sun, moon, or stars, okay? Or planets, any other planets that have a Capricorn energy for you. It's earthy. If you do not know what energies were present when you were born, you're interested in a birth chart or a natal chart analysis, just send me $20 on my Cash App or Venmo, and I will send you a private YouTube link that only you and I can see. Okay, so let's get started. It's for Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Venus, the Senate, Ascendant, Mercury, whatever. Okay, these are just the energies that I'm feeling to, this is just the ones that were highlighted to me for some reason, intuitively. Please help me deliver, I will deliver a message that resonates to someone who is watching, who needs it, so that they can live their most prosperous, rewarding, and fulfilling life. Okay. Enlightenment. Oof. Enlightenment. You might be getting in touch with, like, remembering, like, your deep inner, like, remembrance or your deep inner, you might be starting to remember. Like, you might be starting to remember, like, your inner knowing and stuff like that. You might be getting in touch with that, okay, right now. And for me, this card came out last week, and to me, this is, says simplicity. So, this says simplicity. And to me, it's so funny because I thought the word messenger, I was saying, may I be a messenger for you or whatever. And to me, like, a feather to me means, like, messenger. So that's so funny. because I was thinking it. Okay. 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 Okay, so yeah. Okay, let me see. Okay. What are you missing here? Alright, so this is enlightenment, release, and simplicity. So my Neptune is almost in Capricorn. It is almost in Capricorn, but my descendant is Capricorn. Uranus, you have Uranus and Uranus. Not my own is Uranus. Okay, sorry. I'm not sorry, actually. I'm kind of silly. So this is enlightenment, okay? Alright. So to me, like a solitary sailboat is a symbol for like a journey. You know, and we were talking earlier, and usually one of these videos usually have like a theme, okay? So I feel like this theme is about like solitude and getting comfortable with yourself. So I talked about that with Gemini as well. So this is, to me, this is like a solitary journey, okay? Simplicity, pay attention to the messages and ground, okay? Pay attention to the messages that come through for you and don't throw away all the subtle messages because those are important too. Okay, for Capricorns, to me, like that energy is about like very, strong, like to me, I've had to, like, for instance, for me, like, I've had to really work hard in my life to integrate the, like, the organization and the, those kind of things that are, that are like Capricorn-y. I can't think of the words right now. Okay, but I've had to really really work on that. Like the planning part and the organization and the step-by-step type things. I've really had to integrate that and I think that I've done okay. But this has to do with like let go of the hardness, like letting go of the like perfectionism. Okay, like it has to do with like letting go of that and having, like sometimes that has to do with like OCD and things like that, because a lot of times if you have like OCD or you have to double check, triple check, you know, quadruple check everything, everything has to be in a certain place and everything has to be perfect. It comes from a fear of things falling apart if it's not perfect. You know, it comes from a fear of failing. But to me, if you know, if you get so caught up in the agenda of things and the order of things, then you kind of fail at the flow, you know. And when you fail at the flow, not really fail, but you miss the flow. And when you miss the flow, then you're missing that connection where you get the subtle messages that will help guide you where you want to go and where you want to be. So for Capricorn energy, that is what this is about, is about realizing if you're, you know, just letting things slide, sometimes kind of pick your battles, okay, because not everything needs our energy and our attention like we think it does, okay, because if we're paying attention to all the, if we're paying attention to all the energies, or the, all the things around us, like everything has to be particularly this order, particularly that order, otherwise there'll be chaos, then sometimes we are creating chaos in our own mind when we're doing that. And instead of around us, everything might be perfect around us, but that sometimes it's because there's chaos inside of us. And so we're trying to create order around us when really it's the chaos or the disorder that we have inside of us that we really want to structure. You know? So sometimes that can lead us to enlightenment is like just letting go of it, like releasing it. just sometimes that can lead us to the enlightenment that we seek, or reminding or remembering the enlightenment that we once touched upon. I don't know why I said it like that, but is letting go the idea or the actions or the idea that everything has to be in perfect order. And it seems different. Like, it seems counterintuitive, because it seems like everything has to be a certain way and ordered this way and listed this way and placed this way in order to receive some sort of enlightenment or to get to it. However, that could be the very thing that's stopping you or blocking you from reaching what you want to reach. And so sometimes we have to go the opposite way or do something that seems counterproductive in order to reach what we want. And that's the challenge sometimes. But it's worth it. Because if we're too busy and too focused upon getting everything in working order and making sure everything is perfect, and what we're doing, we're creating disorder in ourselves. You know, we're being too hard on ourselves and being critical of ourselves and things like that. But if we just be gentle on ourselves and realizing there is another way, that we deserve to have peace and we deserve to be gentle on ourselves, then we can reach that which we're seeking. Okay? Okay, so that was for Capricorn. Hello for those who just joined. I am going to be posting the replay. I'm going through some zodiac signs right now. If you have any requests for a personal message, just comment your name or anything and I will get after it, okay? Did that resonate with anyone? These are timeless messages. All right. All right, I'm going to do Pisces now. I'm going to do Pisces energy. This is an energy. It could be Pisces, sun, moon, planets, or what are they called? Axis. Resonates with you? Good. We're tapped in, huh? We're connected somehow. All right, so Lyran soul, 2222. What does 2222 mean to you? I'm curious to know. We all have our own symbolism and messages that come through. I'm a numbers girl big time. I love numbers. I get messages through numbers a lot. All right, so I'm gonna do Pisces energy. Okay, it could be any thing, but if you're interested, if you don't know what energies were present at the time of your birth, then please message me and send me $20 and I will send you a link to a private YouTube video that only you and I could see. I've really been working on choosing my battles. Good. Okay. So here's, this is for, okay, I know which ones I'm going to do for Pisces today. Good for you. It's hard sometimes to choose your battles because it's like, so you're so used to fighting a certain thing. And so it's like, I don't want to lose this because I don't want to lose this battle because it has to be this way. It has to go this way. But what if it doesn't have to go that way? Like, what if you just let it go? What happens then? Especially if it has to do with another person. To me, it represents divinity and wisdom. I love that. Divinity and wisdom. I love that. You know, if you look up the number 2 on the internet, like, it says that a lot of things. But it says something about duality, for one, also, obviously, because, you know. But, 2, sometimes it's like the message of, divinity. I have read that, too. But it means a couple of things for me. Okay, so I feel the need to shuffle these a lot. I don't know why. I don't know why I'm doing that. Okay. It's so weird. I don't know. I just follow the flow. It's like, okay. And that's the one. Okay, Journey to Wholeness. All right, So okay, that's a beautiful photo. Okay, so this card speaks to me about, I'm actually on the path of what if I didn't do the other thing. It's such a weird path. Of the what if I didn't do the other thing. Okay. Like trying new things? Or, I don't think I understand what you're saying. But this is Pisces for me. This is speaking to me about liberation. Obviously, that's a big theme in my life. You know, overcoming fears and things like that. It's about art too. And you see how she's got the rainbow flush going too. You see her? And you know, she's showing her beautiful breasts and her beauty just like that, okay? She's got a beautiful lotus at the top of her head. You know, I've spoken about lotus before. Lotus is gorgeous. It's a beautiful representation of making it through anything and still blooming, because a lotus blooms in the mud even through treacherous times and treacherous circumstances and environments. The lotus flower blooms, okay? The lotus has a lot of symbolism, but she's got her crown of glory, which is her purple hair right there like that. It resonates with the crown chakra. All right, so it's a to me, this is about liberation too. And she is integrating her truest self and letting go of the, it's like she's letting go of the old beliefs that she has to be a certain way. She has to, I know it's not just because she's showing her breast, but just letting go of the idea that she has to be like a good girl per se. Because to me, being good has to do with treating others how you want to be treated and thinking for yourself, you know, and appreciating the things that you want to appreciate, because it is a journey of wholeness, but not by anyone else's standards, but your own. And that does involve like getting a little solitude is not loneliness, but getting in touch with yourself and what it is that does bring liberation for you. And sometimes it has to do, this is, I've talked about this before, I think it was last week with Pisces, about creating art. And there are many ways to create art. You can have your creative expression, and right here on her neck, you see, that's like in between her higher heart and her throat, and it's like light. It's a light right there. So she, it's like she has something to speak or to sing that will light up, you know, her higher heart, like for universal love. And I think that Pisces rules Neptune, or Neptune rules Pisces. It's one of the ones, I believe it is. You see, and in this picture, like her eyes, like it looks like she's been crying a lot, and she's been through it. It looks like she's been crying a lot, but she looks very free. Like her hair and everything is just kind of flowing, and she's got the rainbow colors and everything. And it looks like she's been through a lot in order to be free, but she's free now. And she has let go of the chains and all the old ideas and opinions of others so that she can be liberated herself. Right, and this flower bloomed, you know, no one told it to bloom, she just blooms. She didn't, you know, it doesn't compare itself to others and ask when it should bloom or when it's okay to do it. She just did it because she knew she could bloom, so we could see what was inside. And what was inside is a beautiful yellow star with an eye in it. So she has higher perspective, she can see higher things now because she allowed herself to bloom wherever she was planted. Or wherever she planted herself, even. No one even had to plant her. She planted herself somewhere and bloomed. Also resonates good. And also, like here, like coming from her eyes, there's like, it's like, I know this is just a picture, but these images speak to me. And so in this picture, it looks like as if she's been crying, and the cries are like, the tears are like light blue, obviously the color that people usually paint tears. But to me, that has, for some reason, it's standing out about her throat too, because she's crying. It's like she's crying so much because she wants to express her in some way. It's like she's holding back what she wants to express. And there are so many ways to express, and it could be an art. This is the same thing. So if there's a Pisces watching or listening, either spiritually or here watching this or the replay, then honey, just start doing it. Let go of everybody's, may you let go of anybody's opinions or old beliefs about you. May you, even if it's like memories that you hold deep within that, you know, that are, you're feeling like held back from speaking what it is you want to speak that will help you to feel free. Get the chains off of yourself too, because that just has to do with something, that is deep within you that is dying, like this is like, has a huge urge to be expressed. And this is exactly the same message as last week. So it's as if that somebody that with this Pisces energy is very much holding back from expressing you're holding back yourself from expressing yourself in the way that is healthy for you, that will be very, very good for your life and probably others too. You know, whatever you heal in your life and whatever you express in your life not only just helps you, but it helps everyone as a whole and your descendants and generation after generation. Pisces moon. Yeah. Okay. This has to do with polarity again. Obviously, I'm dealing with a lot of balancing in my life because these keep coming out. But those are two dragons, you see. We were just talking about speaking our truth. I know, right? Yeah. You see how she's just here and she's like surrendered. Because like her hair is just hanging and she's just like, she's surrendered kind of to the magic. And there's that a symbol again. To me, that's like the caduceus. That has to do with like energy medicine. That has to do with like, you know, what is your medicine? You know, what is your, what are, where, you know, mine is love. I like to say that mine is love and communication. You know, I like to communicate in love so that there's understanding. And to me, love is understanding. So this has to do to me, since I said, you know, my medicine for me in my life is love, or communicating in truth that is loving and understanding, to bring understanding. And it's funny that I say that, because these two, like I was talking about earlier, they look like two different things, but they're actually intertwined, and she's integrated them as she surrendered. And you know, we can imagine, like, for you, Pisces, or whoever I'm talking to, whoever this is for, it's almost as if it's coming out, you know, of her throat. Like, you know, she has magic to speak and magic to share creatively, however that is, with the world. And, you know, like, whatever helps this world is helping the universe to... Okay. That's a very heavy message for... I'm actually going to highlight Pisces on this, because this is a very heavy message. This is the second time it's come through for Pisces for me on this channel. So, that's for Pisces. May you feel free, whoever you are, may you feel free to do the things that you want to do here without the judgment of others. May you be able to let go and find gratitude in some way for the things that you've heard that held you back from doing what you want to do or speaking what you want to speak. And may you know that your voice does have power, and you do deserve to be heard, and you do deserve to feel understood and to feel heard. You do deserve to shine in the way that you want to shine. You do deserve to let yourself go from past judgments or past actions, and the fear of the judgments of others as well. You do deserve that, and may you feel that and know that, okay? Alright, I think I'm gonna do Cancer now. Hudson, I will check my messages in a second. I didn't see anything from you, but I will check again. All right. Okay, Cancer energy strong here. All right, this guy's for Cancer. Close my eyes and meditate on those affirmations. Wow, so powerful. Good. Good. Thank you for joining. All right, so Cancer, sun, moon, stars, and planets or axis. This goes for all Cancer energy. If you do not know, I'm just repeating this because I timestamped them on the YouTube video. But if you do not know your what placements were there whenever you were born, then and you're interested in a birth chart analysis, just send me $20 in my Cash App or Venmo, and I will send you a YouTube link that for a private video that only you and I can see. Okay. All right, so this is for Cancer energy. So I'm doing this deck. I don't usually use this deck. I did use it last time. I think I'm gonna make my own too, actually. So. Ooh, it's strong. Hey, Nicole. The dude abides. Okay, I'm done with this deck. Now I'm gonna put two together, actually. Okay, I don't know why I'm gonna use these, but I'm gonna use these. Doing good. I'm alive. How about you? I'm pushing through cysts. Hey, Sean. What's up, guys? So, I'm on Cancer now. I've just done some zodiac signs. The dude abides. Okay. Let's see here. Thank you. So, you do too. Sure, ducky. Sure, ducky. Sure, ducky. You might like ducks. Yeah, Cancer. Right. I just started on Cancer. It's your lucky day in your lucky life. The dude is patiently waiting for you to come on home. Let him do the heavy lifting for a change. No matter what crazy mess you've gotten yourself into, the dude is here with everything you could ever need. The dude's got your back, rock star. Okay. Okay. Okay, so also we have discernment, and it's this dark bird here. It's, you know, it's blackbird, too. Cancer, it's for Cancer. In masculine energy, the sun, and past, present, and future. Okay. Yeah. So, to me, this has to do with, like, shadow energies. The theme has been, like, duality and, like, wholeness and things like that, okay, for this video. Usually, there is a theme. Every time I do this, there's a theme. All between all energies, okay, between all zodiac signs and everybody. So, this has to do, to me, with, for me, with duality, again, but also, like, your, like, darker or shadow aspects, okay? Especially when it comes to your masculine or your sun. All right. Past, present, and future. Also, to me, this speaks about, it's like sometimes it's been the same, like whoever, to me, okay. So whoever, you know, people say that we have the one. you know, this is my one person. This is my one, I don't know why I'm telling this story right now. I don't think I've ever told anybody this, but I feel like it'll resonate with someone who's watching either the replay or right now. So to me, whenever people say, you know, this is my one person or whatever, this is kind of a controversial actually theory or opinion, but I don't care, obviously. I've noticed and have sensed that it's not just one person, okay? To me, it's like one, like, energy or soul aspect that's been present that you've loved, like, your entire existence, that's been present in the past, past, present, and the future. And it's about a familiarity and a resonance that is maybe possibly inside of a human, and it could be inside of a certain human for a certain period of time, depending upon the healing and the amount of, like, ascension or descension that happens in that human while you're with them. So that's why, in my opinion, that a certain relationships don't always work out like forever, because to me it has to do with it, constant change is the only constant, you know, in life, as well as love, okay? So love and change are the only constants, in my opinion, and love doesn't change, okay? So to me, like, every person that I've been with in particular, I haven't been in that many, like, serious relationships. It's not because I don't have the option, but it's just because of a choice. You know, and there's a resonance with all of those that I recognize. It's like a familiarity. And so that, to me, that has to do with, there's something that you can recognize in a person. It's not necessarily like the way they look or their signs or anything like that, but it's like something that's deep inside of humans or us, you know, that is the love that we know. It's a familiarity, it's something that we already know. That's why they say that, you know, they say, like, I knew her when I met her, or it's like love at first sight. It's not necessarily that you fell in love, it's that you remembered a love, because it's like something that resonates inside of you, like you already love them. You know, like, I feel like that too. Like, they, you know, I've always thought, like, I fell in love really fast, but it wasn't about falling in love. I never really fell. It was more of a remembrance of a love that I've had with that, whatever was inside of them, that, you know, while I was with them or when I met them. And so, to me, this has to do with that. And sometimes it is like a shadow energy or like a darker aspect too. And I do love all parts of people, and that I want to say that, you know, that's a blessing and a curse, okay? Because it is. I love very, very deeply, and a lot of Cancers do too. I have noticed that Cancer is very watery and very deeply, you know, connected emotionally, and it's not necessarily a bad thing. It is something heavy sometimes to carry around, but that's only if you're dwelling in it and you're focusing upon the negative or the undesirable, like, aspects of it too. Or if you're holding on, you know, sometimes we can meet someone who helps us heal, but not if we're it's almost like we're remembering impressions of things that happened a long time ago. If you're connected to your memory or your to universal memory or emotions, then when you're with a person and you feel sad all the time, it's like, it's almost like your energy together is like filtering out or purifying, like, old memories or old emotions that weren't able to be filtered out or healed before, okay? And I have noticed that before. I have noticed that when I was with people, is you're like, you're with a wound mate, you know. There's like, to me, there's like a soul mate, a wound mate, you know, a life mate. There's like different ones. And I feel like a lot of us are in touch or are partnered up with people that are our wound mates, if you're like arguing a lot or if you're just sad all the time. And that is about healing, because it's about a resonance or a commonality, like a common wound that you might have together, that comes to the surface in order to be healed and filtered out, so it doesn't have to be experienced again in the future. Yeah, and so it's about integration and using discernment so that you know what it is that is being brought out in you or both of you, so that you don't see the other person as an enemy. You don't see them as like the shadow or whatever, because it's not like that. It's like we're holding energies and parts, aspects of soul and stuff within us and around us that is there not to clash but to complement. So because it brings like a an awareness of what it is that we need to filter out and purify. Because if we start to look at people like our shadow person or whatever, then that's when we like demonize them and we start to look at them like they're an enemy. But if we take away the blame and we stop labeling, then we can see them and ourselves as complementary so that we can come into wholeness and heal and purify those things that need to be healed and purified in love. And that takes understanding, you know. It takes understanding and releasing blame and not looking at the other person as if they're, yes, opportunity for growth. And it takes understanding and not looking at the other person as if they are just always trying to hurt us. Now, that's different for, you know, it's different if the other person literally is trying to hurt you, you know what I mean? But if you're always hurt around them, or if you're always hurting with them, and you're experiencing a lot of hard times with them, it doesn't necessarily mean they're trying to hurt you if they're actually not, like, don't have those intentions. It means that those things are being triggered within you so that you recognize what it is. You can ask yourself, like, what is this teaching me and why am I experiencing this? But it's because you're strong and you're able to heal within love. Love is always stronger, but it's triggering something inside of you that really needs to be filtered or purified out so that it's not experienced again. Okay. Opportunity for growth, that's right. Nicole, did you want a message real quick before I move forward? That was for Cancer, okay. I hope that resonated. Awesome, awesome, awesome. I think it was awesome. I do the bye, it's okay, maybe that I can. If you got one, okay. Yeah, the dude's got your back, Rockstar. It did resonate. Nice. Okay, so for those of you watching now and for the replay, if you want to send donations or tips or whatever, I've got my Venmo and Cash App handle in the title here, and on the replay on YouTube, I have the handles on in the description box below. Okay, so I'm going to do a general message for Nicole here. We haven't gotten together, but I would love to. We can meet at my studio if you'd like. I do have a studio if anyone is interested in knowing more about that. I do guided grounding, guided inner journeys. I am a liberation coach if you need help with anything else. We also do art therapy after the inner journey. That is beautiful. Like with my clients, I'm creating like a mural, and so it's actually pretty beautiful. So far, so if you're interested in meeting or booking an appointment, and on Washington Avenue, I have a studio there to do that. Okay, for Nicole, adventure. Okay, so yours is about inner child healing. So, you know, I do, like I said, you should book like an inner journey, okay? A guided inner journey. I do those. I walk my clients through grounding. And then it's an inner astral discovery. And a lot of my clients have really met like their inner child there. And the inner child has guided them to remember what it is that they kind of lost touch with. Because I feel like a lot of us have lost touch with our passion, or that thing that like our go, you know, our motivation to do, like our creativity. Okay, we talked about creativity for, I remember talking about it with you last time you were on, and like if you do like remember those things you did when you were a little girl, you know. And we do in general, like with public school and stuff like that, You know, I'm not saying that public school is terrible or anything like that, but I believe that some things do need to change as far as like directing them more towards following their passions and stuff, because I do believe in purpose, and we all have inner, like, not necessarily gifts, but like passions and things that we're good at, so we can like work together as a whole, too. But a lot of that is squandered because of this, like, economically, you know, driven society that we've been kind of grandfathered into. But let's imagine if we all got back in touch with our inner child and started doing and remembering those things that we were good at and that we enjoyed doing, how much more passionately can we all live, like, together as a whole and help each other rise as a whole as well in ourselves? So that has to do... a few times, okay, so it does always come out for you, huh? Okay, you have kids, don't you? Like, playtime with your little girls, sometimes, like, that's how I was when the girls were little, is, like, playing with them and doing fun things with them and just letting them kind of lead and stuff. It helped me to get in touch with my inner child, too, because in the day-to-day, you know, hustle and bustle of following the agenda and the things we gotta do, because, you know, you have to, like... you know, we have to make money to just breathe, basically, here, you know what I mean, and the way that it is. And so, like, whenever, as we do that, it's like we start to focus on, like, our drive or our motivation is actually just survival instead. But kids aren't like that. Kids aren't like that at all. It's like their motivation is curiosity and discovery. And I like to stay on that trajectory a lot. That's like, I'm very childlike too in nature, but I like to be that way because it keeps me connected to my inner child, so I don't forget my passion. And a lot of times I've noticed that the inner child in my clients is begging for like to just be free to create and to play. Okay, so we must not forget to play, because that's sometimes, a lot of times, that's where our adventure lies, is in playing and in just doing things that are just for fun. Okay, that could do with dancing. You see how she has the golden like key right there, and she's looking in the mirror. You know, she's looking in the mirror at herself, and she has wings, you know. You know, it's like getting dressed up and just playing with, you know, that sounds kind of weird, but don't not thinking about what others think, but also getting in touch with people and like seeing them. If you notice like kids, and like in the grocery store or wherever you are, if you notice kids that don't even know each other and they're like walking past each other with their family and they start to look at each other like, or somewhere where there's like a playground, the kids, they just walk up to each other like, hey, you want to play? And you know, I think a lot of us, as far as a society, I've noticed, I watch people a lot, and I've noticed that people are like, it's very, not everyone, but I think that we are getting away from that a little bit more, but not, it's like we're just kind of focused only on our own stuff, and that we don't even notice everyone around us. So that's why I, personally, I like to talk to people and be like, how are you doing? Or, you know, give them a hug and stuff like that. And if they want, you know, if they're okay with me coming into their space. But like, kids are like that. It's like they don't ever meet a stranger, and they're just kind of here to just explore. You know, they touch all the, you know, they smell the flowers, and they, you know, they want to touch everything and discover everything. And since this is a journey of discovery, and not only self-discovery but remembrance and discovery of oneness, then, you know, we should definitely not get away from our childlike adventure, our childlike discovery too, and just remember, like, before all the constructs were put upon us, before all the, you know, agenda was put upon us that we had to do this and we had to do that, you know. And a lot of times, like, our very thing that is that can help us rise or help us even be successful is that thing that we came with, that we've covered up, that's still there. And when we get in touch with and meet our inner child and give her a chance to speak and to remind us, you know, to give us some advice, like, you know, what did you want to be when you grow up? Sometimes forgot, you know? And so then that can be the very key to whatever it is, wherever we're trying to go that we're not really getting to yet. I became a first grade teacher after traumatic childhood in public school. Yeah. Yeah, so you became the person that you needed. Right? So you became the person that you maybe needed when you were little. You know? That's beautiful. You have 4 young kids. Yeah, so if you can shift out of being just the mother sometimes and just be one of them with them, not only can that bond help build trust between you guys, and so they see you as like a playtime partner too, and they have fun with you, but that will be good for you as well, because it will remind you of being a child again, because we shouldn't just completely block out, you know, our childhood. That is a very valid part of our journey, is our childhood, and taking what we gained from it as well, of just that innocence, that childlike innocence. And you know, like, instead of, you know, sometimes, you know, our kids, if they're just all playing and having fun, sometimes we can step away from just being the mother, the identity of their mother, and just be a part of them too as a unit, so that you learn from them while they're learning from you as well. I've learned a lot from my kids. They say that, you know, we're supposed to be our kids' teachers, but I've said this several times, you know, I learned a lot more from my kid, my daughters, than they learned from me, and I would say that all day long. But you have to know what to look for and how to learn from them, and what they're teaching you. But that takes really opening your ears and like letting them teach you, and not seeing them as something smaller, but something that sees a perspective that we might be missing. Because kids see in a very innocent, open-minded like perspective, that over time I feel that we as a whole tend to forget, especially if we're allowing media and others to direct the way that we're thinking and how we're seeing things. So so it's about like trying to see things as your children see them, or as you did when you were a child, so that you don't forget. Because I see children as, you know, they just came from the other side, right? So I believe it's around like 7 years old or something when more of that like kind of amnesia like steps in, but it's because of this density. It's because of where we are here in this density. Okay, and not only that, but the programming and some of it's not even intentional, but just like the structuring and the economical, all that stuff. And so to me, like, children come here with a lot of wisdom. Like, I see that as like very sacred and special, and they deserve to be heard. You know, some people have said that, you know, children should be seen and not heard. I definitely 100% do not believe that statement whatsoever. That is a very closed-minded and ignorant concept, in my opinion. Children absolutely deserve to be heard and recognized and valued for what they have to speak and share, so that it doesn't get diluted by, you know, the ideas and the opinions of those who do say those types of things. Needed that. Good. Awesome. Good. That was only one card. Yeah. Hex, yeah. I think I'm gonna do Leo now. Children should absolutely be heard. I have a huge heart for children. It's the message you needed? Good. I'm so glad. Can you please get with me? Schedule an appointment, baby. Even if you don't get a service, we can just get together. There's a lot of different places we can eat or have lunch. That's kind of it's a middle point between you and I. It's not that far from actually, one of the places I get supplies is in... No, it's not. It's not quite in Richmond. Never mind. Never mind. I was just kidding. I have been to Richmond area before when I used to do the sexual education demonstrations for groups. I need to. It's been a year since my last cut. Yeah, but we can do the inner journey too if you want. If you don't want to do hair, we can do that. Do you follow me on my Instagram for hair? No, I don't go. I don't like to shop. I'm a weirdo. I don't know what. I feel like I was born in the wrong time or something. I don't like to shop at all. And Harwin sounds like, you know, people go to the, like, Thanksgiving, Black Friday and stuff. Oh my gosh, that just, like, repels me. For supplies? No, I don't go there we can do both? Okay. No, I don't go there for supplies. It's, never mind. I'm talking about the one on Westheimer. Princess Pro is where I go for some of my supplies. That's not in Richmond. That's in Houston. I don't know what I was thinking. No, No, Harwin to me, yeah, it has the cheapest stuff, but I don't even care about like purses and brand name stuff. Like I've carried the same purse for like a long time. I don't even care what brand it is. I'm just weird. I don't know. That's just how I am. It's not something that I care about. I know, I have friends who, I have been there before. I went with friends before, but it was like, I don't know. Like I'm the type, like if I go like say to the grocery store, like I know what I'm getting and I'm on a mission and I go get it and I leave. So yeah. All right. So I'm going to go to Harwin. Like my clothes, like this is like, I got these from someone else and I've had this for like a really long time. I just like to put together outfits that are like I've had this stuff for a long time. And so I don't like to shop. Westheimer Inns in Richmond. No beauty supplies. You have to find the right store. Yeah. I know. Yeah. So, like, yeah. How about, can I message you and then I'll tell you, like, my openings and stuff and then we can do it? Because we need to get together and one of us needs to make the call. Do it. Alright, this is going to be for Leo. Okay. So, it can be Leo, Sun, Moon, Stars, or Planets, or Axis, okay? If you have no idea what energies were present whenever you were born, and you're interested in a birth chart reading, then you can send me $20 to my Cash App or Venmo that is in the description box or in this handle here on this live, and I will send you a YouTube link with a private video that only you and I can see. Yes, please. Okay. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe my DMs are not coming through because someone else, Lanson, also said that he messaged me. I'm not seeing them for some reason. Yeah, and for those in the replay or those of you watching now, if you're interested in my hair business too, I've been a hairstylist for 22 years. It is Instagram. On Instagram, it's the word 14 underscore moons underscore studio. 14 Moons Studio. 14 Moons. And bonus points for you if you can tell me what planet that is. Okay, this one keeps coming out. Protected by Angels. Yes, and I did cut my hair on a live. You did encourage me to cut my hair. I did cut my hair on a live, girl. And like it's been through a lot since then. Yeah, we're not gonna go into those stories right now, but as a hairstylist, we think our hair is invincible and we're invincible and we can do anything to it, and we go the complete opposite way that we advise our clients, and no one is there to stop us and we screw it up. So but I did like that cut. I needed a change. Okay, babe. Okay. So that keeps coming out. I feel like there is like some sort of angel around me or you guys that is like Leo involved. I do have a Leo moon. Okay. But this is, it's like something that is something to do with a Leo. It is yellow. That has to do with your solar plexus. Okay. Whatever Leo energy that I'm talking to you, it has to do with like keep maintaining your power. Making sure that you do not allow anyone to have power over you. You are quite beautiful and maybe you stand out and others don't like it. You'll let me work, okay? You can talk to me, baby. But we do need to get together, okay? Okay, I'll look for in my messages. I'm going to write that down for both of the ones who said that they messaged me because I do need to get back to you that, okay, so DMs, okay, so I will message you guys, okay, so this has to do with maintaining your power and getting your power back. And not allowing anyone to take your power. I feel like there's a Leo or somebody that has a prominent Leo aspect who possibly like is just very like not necessarily dominant, but like noticeable, and maybe others don't like it. And they think that you're trying to get all the attention, but you're not trying. It's just natural for you. And so what it is like you dim your light, or you dim your personality, or you're quiet more because you don't want to be judged or to be told that, you know, you can't be something, or you can't be a certain way, or yourself, or something like that. It's almost as if okay, so whenever people see, a lot of times whenever people that have so low self-worth or insecurities see that you are strong in your power, which doesn't mean you're more powerful than them, but if they see that you have a strong personality, or that, you know, you are shining, they feel threatened. So they might feel threatened by you enough to where they make you feel like you're small, but you're not small. And if you have a loud personality, if you have a loud voice, or if you have a loud anything, you don't have to be quiet, or you don't have to make it smaller or quieter just so someone else is comfortable. Because them being comfortable isn't your responsibility, it's theirs. Okay, now if it's someone that you can't get away from, or you have to be around, then just know that eventually you keep being yourself, because the more that you allow them to take your power away or to make you feel small, the more power they have over you and control over you. And they eventually start to see that they're not, that you're not actually hurting them. Eventually they do see that you're not a threat, but you're an inspiration. Okay, because to me, like, Leo in general, like the light side of Leo is inspiring, and is it like almost like an advocate for kind of being yourself, or being confident. You know, like, it's not cowardice. You know, they say the cowardly lion, but you're courageous. That to me, the cowardice part of Leo is the darker side. That's the side that cowers down because they feel like they don't want to be they don't want to be a threat to others. They don't want others to feel threatened in their presence, because it's like they're afraid to be themselves and to be big and large and to do what they're good at, because they don't want others to feel like they're small. You see, I love about Leo energy is it's like not, it doesn't ask for the attention, it just naturally does it. It naturally is loud and large and strong, but it doesn't do it for attention, it just naturally gets it. It's because it's inspiring, but that's not up to you to make others be inspired instead of threatened. It's up to them. And I think sometimes like Leo holds it in them that it's their responsibility to be small so others feel comfortable, but that's not it. Don't you dare hold that responsibility. That's not on you. You're here to shine and to be who you are, and whoever it gets uncomfortable is not your fault, and it's not your responsibility at all, or your fault if they feel threatened. It's up to them to realize that, and they will eventually if you just continue being yourself and being as larger than life, if you want to be, or if that's how you feel the most comfortable and fulfilling. Because they say that if you were born into a world you feel like you don't fit in, which you don't fit in, perhaps you were born into the world to help create change in it, you know? So instead of allowing the world or your environment to conform you, what if you were born into a world to bring a new vibration to those around you, to help them feel free and be inspired too, to help them recognize their shine too, you know? So you can do like solar plexus healing, and just like releasing cords. I don't like to say like cord cutting, but to realize if someone is taking your power, it could be someone or it could be something. Sometimes it's an idea or a belief of like some sort of blame or some sort of judgment or something, like if I do this, then this will happen, but it's letting go of that. But and when you do solar plexus healing, it causes you to feel like centered and as if you can go towards the path that you're meant to go on without being held back by the cords of others trying to direct you or trying to shape you in the way they want you to be shaped. Because nobody gets to shape you but you. You know, and I've talked about this with my youngest daughter. So she was talking really quiet, and like I've been working with her whenever I see her. I've seen her when I saw her recently. She was like very quiet and felt like she was holding things back. So I told her, hey, we need to turn that meow into a roar. Okay? Like, don't you purr. If you have something to say, don't purr it out. Roar. So we literally did. We were like, you know, she was talking and, you know, I had to get, you know, she's 12. So I was getting very silly with her. Like, I was like, meow, meow. And then I was like, rawr, like really loud. And she didn't do it at first, but then we did it together. And I think it helped her like clear her throat and to realize like, oh my gosh, it is okay if I'm loud and I'm just as different and a freaking supernova shape if I want to be, you know? It's okay to do that. And so like sometimes it's okay to purr. Sometimes purring is good. Sometimes meowing is good. But if you want yourself to be heard and understood, baby, you need to roar. It doesn't mean you're letting anybody know who's boss. It doesn't mean you're powering over anybody. It just means that you're like not letting anybody take your roar away from you. And that, you know, like back away if you're scared. You know what I mean? Don't come near me and try to quiet me if you're scared or threatened by me. Just let me sit here and roar. And there can be two lions in this jungle. Just roar yourself and don't be held back by my roar. Work on your own roar. We can both roar in the same space. It is okay. My roar should not take away from your roar. Be inspired instead of jealous or threatened. Okay, and that's the second time that I've seen an owl tonight. And to me, owls resonate with, or they are symbols for wisdom. That's so funny, Lance, and because you said something about divinity and wisdom. So that's the third time since I started this video that wisdom has come up. And it came up last time too, and I didn't even touch on it. But wisdom to me is about experiences, all right? Okay, so we're coming out of Leo now because this is just the general message. So this is about wisdom, okay? So wisdom comes from experience to me, and sometimes, you know, they say that knowledge turns into wisdom. It doesn't necessarily to me like turn into wisdom, but in order to have experiences, we do need knowledge of things too. And if we cannot gain wisdom from experience unless we have the ability to look back on our experiences and ask ourselves what we learned from it or what it was for, like what is this teaching me? And that kind of thing. I talk about this a lot with my clients. Like, what is it teaching you? The cure for pain is the pain. That's by Rumi. And it doesn't have to be pain, but it can be like any kind of experience that you went through. And that's how you let go of like blame or let go of like stories that you're making up in your head because of emotions. It has to do with letting go of the emotions of experiences and filtering them out and letting them, because sometimes our emotions can cloud our lens. We can look at things in a lens or glasses of our emotions that we're experiencing at the time. And if we can filter through those emotions and ask ourselves why we're feeling those emotions, it may not have to do with those experiences at all, but past ideas of things. And if we can let go of those emotions and look at it from a different point of view, from a like a higher perspective, we can look at our experience and say, wow, this is what I gained from that, and find gratitude for it. Then over time, after all those blankets start coming off, those layers, I call them blankets whenever we're doing healing, because it's like layers. And once we get past those layers and let go of those things and really dig deep then that's when we can access like our inner wisdom that we all have access to. And to me, like, wisdom is not just in one person or this person or this person's wisdom. It's a universal wisdom that we all have the ability and capacity to connect with, dependent upon the level of healing that we're able or that we are committed to doing. Healing is very, it's vital to connecting with universal wisdom too. And it's inside of us. It's not anywhere, you know, in a book or in a place or whatever. That can help guide us to that inner wisdom. Those things can. But those are just inspiration that we need and that we can draw upon to reach that inner wisdom. We all have the ability to access inner wisdom, and it is absolutely universal, just like truth is. And that's why it's important to not feel squandered or held back by, you know, if someone else has reached a level of wisdom, or, you know, not reached a level, like gotten a, you know, connected to a level of wisdom and we haven't yet, and we feel like a little bit maybe jealous, or we feel a little bit like smaller because they have. It doesn't have anything to do with that person. It has to do with that universal wisdom that we haven't yet connected to because of the healing that we haven't done yet. And if we are committed and dedicated to healing and to get into that space, then we can walk in wisdom. And if you walk in wisdom, man, and that's when you start seeing the beauty and the joy around you, and we can expand in love as a whole. And to me, that is my purpose and my cause, and that is also for a lot of light workers that I know and have connected with on here. And just walking in wisdom and expanding in love, not only within ourselves, but within the universe. And when we are connected to that deep inner wisdom that is universal, then that's when we can be the torch that we need to be in these places, so that we can connect and share a torch all around. Okay, and this, that also helps, like there are like elemental energies and things. This says Believe in Magic, Journey by Moonlight. Okay, I don't know if you're, any of you are really connected like to the moon and things like that. The moon to me isn't like, some people see it as like dark, a dark energy or dark symbolism. I don't at all. I see the moon and feel the moon as very like nurturing. And to me, it doesn't, you know, I don't do any kind of witchcraft or anything like that, okay? I prefer not to mess with the energetics of, like, to me, divine order and, like, vibrationally, besides with inside of me, which is converting the lower vibrational, like, emotions and thoughts and perspectives into higher. Okay, it's a conversion of energy. It's a law of conservation of energy, okay? But I see it as, I see the moon as, like, it's a luminary for the night, you know. But it not only has like it's reflected from the, okay, I don't know why I'm getting this, but I'm also like, this has me connecting to like the black moon energy for some reason. Okay, and I've talked about this before, but to me, like, the black moon is not necessarily like something scary or something evil or something really dark, okay? But this is like elementals and a connection with, there are energies everywhere, okay? And it's, a lot of stuff is not like really necessarily like noticed or talked about. But I do sense them. I sense all those energies all the time. And to me, like, a lot of old beliefs or things that have been written or talked about says that these are evil, or the moon is evil. And like, sometimes it's, to me, that the idea that it is and the judgment that it is makes it so. But in order to see things in a different way and to convert that, transform that energy from that to that, and to have a balance, is to open your mind and to let go of the idea that those things are evil. Because how are they? I don't know. I can't tell you how. Can you tell me how that's evil? I can't tell you how. But on the back, so behind the moon, so the black moon, you know, you might have like, I have black moon in Aquarius. And so in the eighth house, and so whenever you have a if you know your black moon placement, it shines light upon the things that it's like the shadowy things that maybe that are not, like, I say, frowned upon in like society or like behavior and things like that, and it just accepting them, just accepting the dark part, the darker parts of you that have not had a light shown on them before, so they can be seen. But it's a mathematical point behind the moon, and what's behind the moon is it's dark right there because the sun is not shining on that part. So just imagine, like, it's on the other side of the the world from the sun, and so it's gaining light from the sun on that one side, but on the other side there's no light shining on it. But what about the stars? The stars and stuff. You're welcome, thank you for your decency. I don't know what you mean. Are you talking about my message? Okay. So the stars, to me, I've visualized this, or I've studied this before, and I've really gone into really deep thought about this, because, like, what makes it evil? Like, what makes it bad? I don't know. But you see, on the other side of the moon, what if it's not even dark? Like, you know, because the stars move around and the other planets, like, move around. And what if it is being given light, but it's just not from the sun? What makes that evil? Is it bad because we just don't know what's back there? Well, then I want to know what's back there, because I'm connected with my inner child and my curiosity, and curiosity did not kill the cat. No. No, I don't think so. So for some reason, this is some kind of a general message that I'm getting and tapping into. It has to do for someone that is watching now, or someone who is watching the replay, but it has to do with not being afraid to discover and explore the darker parts of yourself and being okay with it, and letting go of the idea or the judgment from someone else or even yourself that it's bad or evil, because it may not necessarily be so. But if it is bad and it's something that goes against the golden rule, in my opinion, if if you care about my opinion, you know, obviously you do because you're watching this, but the golden rule, you know, treat others how you want to be treated. You know what I mean? So if it goes against that and it hurts somebody, that's a different story. Then if it is, then it's about asking yourself, you know, why do I want to hurt someone? Is it because I'm in pain inside, or is it because I was taught the pain and that I don't know anything else? Is it because I see love as painful? Is it because that's how I see love, is getting pain? You know what I mean? And be gentle with yourself. Most of the time, you see, like, the darker parts of us, the darker aspects of us, or the things that are seen as, like, evil or bad or dark, aren't necessarily so at all. They're just not seen. I want to look at them. I want to know where they came from. I like apples. If you get that, message me, because we are friends. Okay, that was a general message. Okay, I did some zodiacs, and now I want to do, I already did Gemini, I want to do Taurus next. Okay, I will be posting a replay. If you would like to leave a donation or something, I do have Venmo and Cash App handle on the title of this and in the description box below on YouTube when I post a replay. These will be timestamped, so if you have to leave or if you get kicked off, then I have a YouTube link in my bio to watch this. I'll be right back. Hello. Hi, Gil. Okay, so I'm gonna do a Taurus. Do you have Taurus placements? All right, so for Taurus, if you don't know what energies were present when you were born and you're interested in a birth chart analysis or a natal chart analysis, send me $20 in my Cash App or Venmo, and I will send you a YouTube link that is private that only you and I can see, okay? Through a video. All right, so Taurus, let's see here. I'm gonna do the singing bowl again real quick. Visualize or imagine it kind of dissipating now. Okay, I'm gonna stop, but I am gonna be working on this for myself later because I do feel an energy kind of leaving me as I do this. Having a coughing fit. Oh, I'm telling you, you should gargle with salt water or do some singing. Sometimes, you know, if you go somewhere where you can do it, you can just start screaming or yelling loudly, and that kind of thing. Also, like I said, singing, yelling very loudly, without, you know, obviously not hurting your vocal cords, but also breathing into that space. You know, breathe in, and as you're exhaling, you can just imagine, like, something being lifted away, third eye pressure too for you, okay. I did this, like, a couple of years ago, but I'll probably do a video just with the, sound healing, if you guys are interested. I think I am gonna do that, actually. Okay, so I'm gonna do Taurus now. Taurus energy. Okay, this can be sun, moon, any axis, or any planets or stars. This is just a Taurus energy as a whole. Okay, Taurus. The green ones, I'm seeing the green ones, these green ones for some reason. Okay. Taurus. Okay, so I just saw like green, okay, cool. So yeah, whenever I was getting my certification in spirituality, health and healing, I was learning a lot about sound healing and how beautiful and amazing sound healing is, like how actually it's like an ancient form of healing. I say ancient, but it's like always been here. That like somehow, like with the pharmaceuticals and stuff, we've kind of gotten away from or forgotten as a whole. But as we access and we're connected more deeply with those, that universal wisdom and truth, then we start to remember those things, and you know, we're in touch with them, okay? So, because it's a vibe, everything's vibrational. None of it's personal, it's all vibrational, you know? That's what I like to say. So, like, it's important what, you know, like, music you're listening to. I don't know if you've heard this before, but, or read about it or learned about it, but you probably have. But you know, they have they've done a lot of research or studies on sound and how much it affects us as humans and as living beings. They have terrariums and things like greenhouses like that, where they have actually done a lot of research and studies on types of music and things spoken to plants. Plants are living beings too, and things like hard music and like heavy metal and things like that. I'm not saying you shouldn't listen to it, that's your choice, but whenever those types of like harsh sounds were played around in the plants, you know, they wilted and they didn't grow to their full potential. But whenever they played like classical music or like ambient music and healing soft, you know, encouraging sounds and words, then they bloomed in vibration and to their, you know, full beauty. And to me, that proves a lot about, you know, what sound, even sound of people, like people, what they're speaking over you and around you, and what noises that, you know, slamming sounds and those kind of like racket and like, I don't know why I said that word, and things like that are, they do change us and like shock us, and it does change us, change our like mood, it can over time. But if you're listening to things that are like resonate, like if you look on YouTube and you can put in sound healing like hertz, I was wrong in one of my videos, it's 528 hertz, it's called the miracle tone, and it's a beautiful sound. Okay, so let's see, we got, okay, so to me this has to do with duality again, okay? So this is for Taurians, energy, okay? So let's see here, we got, the seasons. Okay, so whoever is connected here in this video or in the replay that has Taurian energy, this has to go with, has to do with you going through certain seasons, and you're just kind of, you know, don't forget that or remember that this is not the only way it's gonna be. Okay, like I said, I don't know who this is for, and it is timeless, so whenever you're watching this, whoever you are, this isn't the way that it's gonna be forever. There are seasons to things. You know, this is a season you're walking through, and sometimes it can feel as if this season's gonna be like this forever. And like, when is this gonna change? You know, some, you know, like people, you know, places that go through like really harsh winters and things like that, you know, that is if it's your choice to live there, then move somewhere tropical if you don't want to be there, you know, if you have a ability to do that, you know what I mean? But it can feel like that emotionally to you and like mentally. If you're going through a really hard, like harsh winter per se, not necessarily like in the weather of your location or environment, but within you, if you're going through a really hard time, just know that the season will change eventually, but you do have the ability and the responsibility of doing what you can to make the change. You know, it goes, that has to do with what I was talking about earlier, like conversion of that. You can transform that energy somehow, and even if it's just little by little, you can. Okay, I feel like I'm talking to someone that deals with like depression and anxiety, okay? You don't necessarily have to be like get on like antidepressants or anti-anxiety and things like that. There are other ways to do it, okay? You know, like for instance, like medications and stuff. Like if you need medication and it benefits your life in some way, then that's fine. You know, that's up to you. And it's only up to you. But if there's more side effects from it than the benefits, then that's an issue. So things like brain supplements, like 5-HTP. I love 5-HTP. It's a neurotransmitter support that can help you get your dopamine and serotonin levels back to normal, as well as exercise and getting sunlight. I think that with the technology and the things that, like, the indoors, there are a lot more, there's been studies have shown that there are more bacteria and microbes floating around inside of buildings. If we don't clear it, then there are, like, outside. And just getting outside and getting some fresh air will help you exponentially, as well as exercise. You can start a new exercise program, and if you have a hard time getting into the habit of starting or continuing, even starting the exercise program, just have some foresight and look into the future of, like, you know, not look into the future like, you know, like a crystal ball type of thing. I mean, like, perspective, you know, like, look back, like, in 5 years, am I gonna wish that I had done something back then? Probably. So what is it that you want, what is it that you would want to change? You know, would it be your well-being? You know what I'm saying? So what you can do is you can just put it in your calendar, just put it in your phone, like, go for a walk outside, or go for a walk along the beach, or whatever, something like that. And if you just do it now, as I'm speaking, instead of procrastinating, because if you are in a state of, like, depression and anxiety or anxiety, then it can be hard to remember, because you're in a momentum of lower perspective, and you're in a momentum of, like, lower vibrations, okay? So you're watching this for a reason. So as I'm speaking right now, just go ahead and pick up your phone. You already have your phone with you. Go ahead and go to your calendar now and just put it in there. Just put it in there for every day. There's an option to put it in every day. Go for a walk. Put it in your, go ahead and do it now. Go for a walk. Walk outside barefoot. Go ahead and do it now so you don't forget or you don't procrastinate. Okay? Or it can be call a friend. Okay? Go ahead and do that now. So that way you do it. Like, okay? You can go for a jog. It can be doing some squats or some push-ups or something, because getting that your circulation going in your body and treating your body well is good for your spirit and your soul too. It's good for your heart and your mind as well. Okay. All right. So whoever that is, the season does change. It will change, but you have the opportunity to change it with one little thing at a time, because what you do is who you are. It's not about what your name is. It's not about how you feel. It's about what you do. And you can do it. You can do it. And if you're in a really low space and you're in a dark place, it doesn't have to stay that way. But you get to choose if you stay there or not. Generally, you do. Okay? And so if you are in a really dark place, you can look at it and shift your perspective into, this is an opportunity for me to rise higher and to change this season into something optimistic and happy. And so that way I can say, start from the bottom, now we hit, you know? So if you go through a really dark place and you're at the bottom, you know, you feel like you're at the, like, really low point of your life, don't give up. But just know that this is a place for you to gain wisdom whenever you get through it. Because when you're in that next season, you're going to be able to look back and say, dang, what if I would have given up? Wow. I'm so glad I put that in my calendar. And I believed in myself enough to keep going. You're going to be able to say, dang, I'm so glad that I valued my life enough to believe I could switch the season myself. Because the seasons can change on the outside of your life, but you have to change them on the inside of you too. You can do it. But, and you know, sometimes it takes talking to yourself, encouraging yourself to, what is it that makes me keep going? What is it that makes me want to keep going? What do I believe in? Can I still do what I wanted to do? Yes, you can. Yes, you can. But you can do one step at a time. It can absolutely change with something as simple as going for a walk every day. Because you never know, that walk might turn into a jog, and you might meet somebody that is your best friend one day on the jog. You might find a dog and that someone is holding on a leash that, that animals are incredibly healing. You might walk by somebody that smiles at you and you haven't been noticed in a while. You might meet somebody or see something that restores your faith in yourself and in humanity and in your life. You never know. It doesn't have to just be a walk. It's never just a walk. Just get outside. You can change the seasons. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And those walks eventually turn into adventures. And if you need to cry, I talked about this last time, so I'm talking to one tourist in particular. If you need to cry, let it go. Just let it out. It ain't gonna be scary. It'll be scary if you hold it in. Just let it out. The reason I said cry is because of this waterfall back here. It can feel like that sometimes. You know, and if you have a lot of emotions to flood through and to let go of, do it. Because then it might help you discover and remember the adventures that you did want to go on. It might help you remember it might uncover the passion and the actual, bucket list that you may have forgotten about that you thought you couldn't accomplish. The only thing, the thing that's hold, that's covering up the remembrance or the seeing those things is your emotions that you're holding in. Okay. It doesn't have to be cold for him. I feel like a tourist that watches this like later or now or something is like needed to hear that. All right. All right, so let's see here. I'm gonna take a second to breathe. I'm gonna plug in my phone before it dies to I don't know where they are, where it is. There it is, babe. Okay. All right, so I think I'm gonna do Scorpio now. I didn't do it last time, I don't know why. But I'm going to. Hey. Scorpio. So here we go. Okay. Oh. Alright, so we're going to do Scorpio energy. This can be sun, moon, planets, or stars, or axis. It's just an energy in particular. If you're not familiar, if you don't know what energies were present when you were born, then you can just send me, and you're curious or interested in the birth chart analysis or natal chart analysis, just send me $20 in my Venmo or Cash App, and I'll send you a YouTube link that is private that only you and I can see, okay? So this goes for, this is for Scorpio energy. I saw this deck for some reason. So you might have Scorpio energy in your chart. It could be ascendant, descendant. It could be anything at all. My Pluto is in Scorpio, as well as Saturn. Anger. It's so funny because this is number 28. 2 is Taurus and 8 is Scorpio to me. Okay, I'm gonna do some more because. Okay, this might be like, I don't. No, I'm gonna do a different deck because this is like more of a personal message for me, so I'm gonna do something else, okay? I'm gonna do this for Scorpio. Here we go. So I am gonna be posting the replay for those who are here now, and I will. My YouTube link is in the bio, and I'll be timestamping them. Scorpio, it's here. Okay. So to me, like, this speaks about. This is soul fragments number 33. So this speaks to me about trauma. It speaks to me about maybe there is a Scorpio energy around. There is some trauma that is being healed. This goes for Scorpio as a whole, okay? And you know, whenever we experience trauma and things that are very hard to deal with, what happens is, essentially, I believe theoretically that there are parts of us that kind of escape. Because it's hard to deal with, and so we kind of tend to sometimes escape in order to cope with because it's like something that we can't deal with, or it might remind us of something we've been through before that we don't want to see or experience again. Okay, and it's like, what happens to those soul parts? What happened to those aspects of us? You know, what happens to them? So what happens is what we need to do is access or get in touch with what it is that's causing some sort of pain inside of us. Or if you have problems like OCD or like a control issue, sometimes it is like a control issue that is an indicator. It's indicative of some trauma that you may have gone through that caused you to feel like you have to control everything. So whatever that is that caused you to have a fragmented part doesn't happen again. Okay, so control, and whenever you have control, I say issues, but whenever you feel like you have to control everything or a person, you have to a person, or it could be like even your entire life, if you're not able to be in the flow and you're in a state of just control, then that's that derives from fear. So to me, fear is an illusion, and what it is you've painted an illusion of what will happen if you don't have control of a situation or a person. And so when I say illusion, it's something that we need to let go of in order to heal it. And so it's an idea, and it's a projected future or a projected outcome of what might happen or what might come about if we don't have control of the situation. Okay, but the thing is, what happens is it's very counterproductive, because whenever we get out of the state of flow and whenever we have to have control of everything, what happens is we are creating disaster for ourselves anyways. Okay, and whatever you think and whatever like projected outcome you think might happen if you don't have control, there is a very like 99.9% chance that it's not gonna fall apart. The only reason that you think it's gonna fall apart or something terrible is gonna happen because something happened before that was hard for you to deal with, and it was very painful. Okay, And so you can call your soul. It gets it's about, this is about soul retrieval. This is about fragments of parts of you that have been in pain. Okay, they've been in pain, and these are fragmented parts of you that are hard to deal with, because it's like maybe you don't remember, hey Tessa, it's that maybe you don't remember the whatever it was, but if you call your soul parts back and you, it's like a soul retrieval, okay, then what happens is you start to remember those things, and it might give you, you know, like, I don't want to say like nightmares, but you might get some memories or some experiences where you start to recognize or remember what it was that caused it. And instead of, like, you got to get past like the emotional part of it and not be afraid to experience or remember those things. Don't be afraid to remember or experience those things again, because that's going to be the key to your healing and the key to you like being free from the idea that you have to control everything, because control is the opposite of freedom. It's the opposite. To me, it's like flow is the opposite of control as well. And if you're not in a state of flow and you're in a state of control, then you're not connected to your highest timeline. You're in a life or a timeline of like your own, like what you think is best. And I'm not saying like you don't have the right idea or you don't know what's best at all. It's just that, you know, if you're like, if you believe like me that there is always something greater, then the flow is where it's at. And that takes you like stopping and breathing and just letting go of it and just being like, okay, what is it that makes me want to control everything or control this or make sure this is perfect? Like, what is it? Is it because of something that happened to me that I don't want to happen again? Probably. You know what I mean? And why is it scary for me? Like, why do I think it's gonna happen again? Because I really don't want it to happen again. Well, it's probably not. The reason I say that is that once you gain back those parts of you and you're able to look at it from that view of, all right, what was it teaching me and why didn't I want to be a part of that at the time? It may not even be as scary or as painful as it was back then. Okay, whatever it is about. But if you can do that and forgive whoever is involved in the situation and yourself, then that immediately raises the vibration of those emotions and it allows it to be filtered out. And then you can find gratitude and look at it in a different way. When you do that, it does raise the frequency of the entire situation and the memory and the emotions of it. Because forgiveness and acceptance is they're higher vibrations. And so is gratitude. So it really does transform the energy of that situation. And it allows you to be more whole with yourself so that you don't feel scattered. I feel like this is about also scattered energy. Like if you feel like you're in a bunch of places at once, that, you know, they, like, it's hard for you to like you have to deal with like everything all at one time, you know, but you don't. So if you can center yourself and, you know, do like I said, just you can look that up or research that or learn about that, like soul retrieval. You can ask me if you want to, but like soul retrieval practices, it's not like really like our soul per se, but it's like parts of us that are kind of lost in the shuffle that have dealt with a lot of pain and were ignored or rejected or even denied, that escaped, you know, that we didn't want to deal with. It's essentially, it's energy that we don't want it, that we're ignoring, and so like in your state of control, it's continuing to reject and ignore and deny those parts of us that actually need us to look at them and come to a state of acceptance and forgiveness in it, about it, the situation. Okay, and that can free you big time. Because if you're in a state of control, I said this with Capricorn, the same with, so Capricorn and Scorpio have similar messages tonight. But so if you're watching the replay, these are timeless. But it has to do with letting go of that state of control and knowing that you can feel free again. You're holding yourself in chains, or basically like kind of imprisonment or entrapment in your mind by holding on to those illusions of fear that everything's gonna fall apart if you don't have a hold of the reins all the time. And the way that you heal that, if it is like OCD or perfectionism, is allow yourself to mess up sometimes. And watch yourself. Pay attention to how you act if you spill something, or if, you know, if it's something about, like, everything has to be in perfect order. It's the same thing with Capricorn. The way that you heal it is to let it fall apart. And then, you know, see what happens. Let things slide sometimes and just see what happens. And, you know, after that, you'll be like, wait a minute, it didn't even fall apart. And a lot of times, most of the time, if it looks like things are falling apart, they're not falling apart. They're coming together. You know, Scorpio, I see Scorpio as like the phoenix rising. I see it like that. That's how I see it. And, you know, the phoenix comes up from the ashes, but the ashes are not meant for you to stay in. You know what I mean? You got to get up and rise and know that dust and all that stuff's gonna fall off of you. You know, you don't have to like swim your wings in these ashes. You don't belong there. You don't belong there. You got wings. You can rise up from those ashes and be free to fly, but you have to let yourself do it. And of course, that's a metaphor, I know. But the phoenix is a very strong symbolism that is sacred and beautiful to me, if you don't know. But it's you know, you've been through fire. You've been through the fire, and you can come out strong. But you don't have to stay there trying to control everything. If that's, like, I see you, like, trying to walk through this tunnel of, like, you know, you're shaping the tunnel yourself, and it's like, you, if you don't keep it this exact same size and this exact same way and this exact same color, then it's like fear of the unknown, and then you don't know what the heck's gonna happen. It might fall, it might be something really bad might happen, but you know, it probably isn't. What will it look like and what will it be like if you don't try to control it? What if it's good? What if it's not hard at all? What if what you're doing, the way you're doing it, is way harder than it would be if you let go? You don't know that unless you try to let go. You shouldn't have to try to let go either. You shouldn't have to try. You just do it. You're trying hard right now. Just stop trying. See what happens. You know? And a lot of times in our state of rest, in our state of letting go, that's where the answers come in. That's when things start to really take shape. But we're not doing it. It's vibrational. I call that divine order. Because to me, spirituality and science go together. Because it's about frequency. You know? Okay, I'm going to read a little bit of this real quick. This is still for Scorpio. I'm going to read a little bit of this page here. Okay. Page 33. Yeah, recalling lost soul fragments. So here's an affirmation for you. I am the master of my own mind. I am ready to move on. Fear-based experiences need to be addressed now. Past life regression could be beneficial to create understanding of phobias, deep-seated fears, or subconscious patterns that have previously controlled areas of your life. Reclaim your power. So that has to do with discovering the origin of the pain, discovering the origin of where, you know, the wound that you're deriving your need, your illusory need to control everything. Okay, and realizing that it's not preventing pain, but you're causing more pain by keeping control of it, of everything. Makes sense? The life of our soul is infinite. Yeah, recall the fragments with love, healing, and understanding. It allows the soul to continue moving forward without the individual feeling stuck in the past or unable to get over an issue or an event. Empowering and liberating. Retrieval is recommended if you feel you are missing parts of yourself. Yeah. Okay, that was for Scorpio. Okay, does anyone want like a personal message before I move on to the next? If you do, just let me know. I love you guys. Thanks for watching. I'm gonna do, let's see, if no one comments, I'm gonna go ahead and move on to. No, I haven't done Virgo. You want me to do Virgo? I will. Okay. That's okay. I haven't done Virgo yet. I will. I'll do it right now. Okay, I don't know why I skipped that. I'm skipping the same ones that I skipped. Last time. You're welcome. All right, let me just connect real quick. Okay, I'm gonna ground real quick. I need to ground this happen to Virgo real quick, okay? Are you a Virgo sun? Yeah, I feel like you've graduated a little bit more. Not graduated, but integrated a lot more than you had. Hold on. Virgo's in the house. Virgo sun. Yeah, okay. Lanson, do you have a lot of air? Okay, Virgo, let's see here. Here we go. What's Stuart?
Let's do it, baby.
Okay, I don't know who that. Your ascendant is Gemini. You have a Gemini ascendant. Your moon is in Taurus. Okay. You missed Taurus. Make sure that, or maybe you didn't, but watch the replay. I'm going to be posting it on YouTube. The link's in my bio. And I will be. I will be timestamping it as well, the video. If you're interested, so for Virgo, if you're interested in a birth chart analysis, you don't know what energies were present when you were born, then send me $20 to my Cash App or Venmo. Tips and donations are welcome. And I will send you a private YouTube link to a video that only you and I can see, okay? All right, so this is for Virgo, let's see. Can be sun, moon, rising, any planets or stars that we're accessing, okay? I believe you have a lot of Libra energy, okay. Alright, so I do, I'm sensing that for some reason. Alright, here we go. I'm having a hard time connecting with Virgo for some reason. Hold on. Virgo feels far away tonight. I don't know why. It feels like It's okay. It doesn't have to be. I'm still connected. It's okay. I don't have to. I can connect through other energies too. Okay. All right. Hold on, I don't usually have this much of a, like, glitch in my connection, but there's probably, maybe there's a reason for that. But you guys have inner Virgo, okay. So I'm not gonna do the cards right now. I'm gonna do something real, like, different. So I'm just gonna do, like a free draw real quick. Okay. Okay, so this is weird, I know. You feel very far away too tonight? Okay. So that's what I got. Okay, that's my free draw. And if you see my fingernails, okay, if you saw my fingernails, it's because I'm an artist and I almost never have clean fingernails. They are clean, but there's like hair color and all kinds of other stuff. Oh, nails, okay, so let's see. So, like to me, this looks like a sleigh. This has to do with like the spiral is very symbolic. It's also like the kind of the creation of life. All right, so it's almost like you are pregnant with a creation or something, and but it's like, it has to do with you believing that it's good. Think like Santa Claus, like, you know, like the tradition or the old like belief of Santa Claus, and how Santa Claus like has this sleigh of gifts that are for others and stuff. It doesn't necessarily have to be like you're delivering presents to people and things like that, but it's like, to me, it speaks about, you know, whatever you're creating, sometimes you don't even know what you're creating, but you're creating it with your actions and like your words and your intentions. Okay. So this has to do with you believing that it's good. Like if you believe that it's good and your intentions are good and your trajectory is in the right place, then it will be. If you believe that it's not good and you believe that you're creating something that is not something you want to create, then you can do that, you know, but you don't want to do that. Because it won't be good for you either. Okay, just remember the things that you do and the things you say and the actions that you take, they do boomerang back to you eventually. That's physics. That, you know, like there's old beliefs of like, you know, karma and like, you know, it goes around, comes around, da da da. Those things do have a ring of truth to them because that's how physics works. Okay, there is a circle that happens, okay? Just like the spiral that are just true. Okay, and you don't want that to boomerang back to you. That's why I say treat others how you want to be treated, because it does come back to you somehow. Okay, and it might, you know, you might be in a space where it feels like, you know, no one has given you or treated you, or you haven't received quite what, you know, you've put out. But don't lose hope. I mean, there is maybe some truth needs to happen. I don't know. This is kind of deep, than I was expecting. Manifestation, I'm the creator of my reality. Yes, but sometimes, okay, I don't want to get into that, but it's like my personal stuff that I've been going through that really does need to be somehow revealed more clearly to me too. But it's not, okay, so yes, you're the creative reality. However, there are other energies and intentions that are involved, because see how we're all connected. You got to think of yourself as a whole, as part of a whole, okay? Because it's not just like, okay, so if I were to say like, I'm the creator of everything, like I'm the creator of my life, then that is completely disregarding the fact that I am a holder of universal energy. And I am a part of the whole fire, you know, a torch of the entire fire that is one. If that makes sense? So if you are not aligned with the intentions of the majority of those who hold and are bearers of truth and light, then you're basically going against the grain, and you're disconnecting yourself from that yourself. Okay, so if you align with your inner truth and your inner wisdom and your purpose and intentions, then you will easily and naturally connect with the intentions and the direction of the whole. Okay, and that has to do with connectedness and remembering that we're connected, okay? Because it, you know, yes, it is about you and yourself and things like that, but if it doesn't align with like the whole of one, then you are going against the grain, and you're asking to be like almost separated from the whole of like with good, of good intentions. If that makes sense, you know? Because in general, like the majority of those who are like us, I say those who are like us, those who are tapped into the same things that we are, we are for good intentions of the whole. And if we heal ourselves and we are doing good things for us, then it is in effect good for the whole. Okay? But if, you know, but if we're trying to manifest purposefully for something that is, you know, we believe isn't going to be good, then it's not going to be high vibrational. Okay? See what I'm saying? Yeah. Do you get what I'm saying? All right, cool. I have a whole world inside of me begging to come out. I know that's right. You're so great at liberation. Thank you. Oh, well, so are you. Maybe you're recognizing that in me that's also within you. Yeah, and so, okay, so since we were talking about your throat chakra and stuff like that, I see like this sleigh, and I don't know if you see the same things I'm seeing, but it's about your perspective, of course, but you see how he's like it's almost like he's driving or flying this sleigh with this like universal energy there, and you just said that you have a world inside of you begging to come out. Yeah. So it's like he's not only driving the sleigh or flying it, then it's like he's delivering it. Like, how are you delivering that world inside of you? In what way are you doing it? I feel every chain falling off right now. Nice, that's awesome. But in what way are you delivering the world you're saying that's inside of you? Like, in what way? Is it through art? I mean, is it through some sort of other creative expression? Is it through speaking or singing? Right? And if you connect with, you can connect with what's inside of you and through your crown, then you can actually like sing songs that can help yourself and others, like through just simply just the vibration. Okay, if your intentions are high and you have a higher perspective, okay? I don't think that was just for Virgo, but that's what I'm getting. So just have the intention, just know that your intentions, if your intentions are good and your intentions are for the highest good of yourself and for all, then they will be. But if you don't have high intentions for yourself and others, ask yourself why. Like, what is that? Is it like a distrust that you can create something good? Is it like a belief that you can, that you always create something that's distasteful or displeasing? Do you believe that? Or does that come from past experience? Have you manifested accidentally or on purpose something that is not good for the whole or for you? Have you done that in the past? If so, then that has to do with letting go of your past memories and your past intentions as well. And if you want something negative or low vibrational to happen for yourself or others, why? Is that because, do you believe that's the only option you have? Why do you believe that? Is it because someone said that you only create bad things? Do you believe that? If you believe that, then it makes it true. If you believe you have capability and you're able to create something really good for yourself and others, then that's what's true. You love art? Yeah, me too. Art is everything. Everything is art. You know, when I start to do art therapy with my clients, almost every single one of them is like, I don't know, I'm not an artist. And then they do the inner journey and they tap into that inner artist through their, you know, piece and create, they tap in, they connect with their creativity. And, you know, we realize as a whole that we're all artists. It's just not all of us have tapped into it yet. And, you know, it doesn't matter what, like, it looks like in the middle of it or even at the end, because art is meant to be viewed or interpreted by the viewer, you know. It doesn't have, you know, it's not about the journey when it comes to, I mean, it's not about the destination when it comes to creating art. It's about the journey. The journey is what makes it beautiful. I have a deep wound from your angel life. Don't we all? Don't we all? Good job. Heck yeah. You know what you're doing. You know what you're doing. You know what? And I want to say this. If we allow others to, like, somebody might think that we don't create good, or that we're bad, or that we're evil, or whatever. Their idea and opinion of us might be a lot. It might be really strong, but if we lose our power and we don't keep connecting to that, ourself and our inner, keep our inner power, reclaim our, keep our power, then that can over, their beliefs and opinions of us can overpower our own belief that everything we create is good. So that goes along with reclaiming our power too, because others can greatly dilute or change the trajectory of what we're creating by the power of their words and their beliefs and opinions. But that's our opportunity to rise up in our power and say, no, that's not me. No. Yeah. So yeah, that's the theme of tonight, of this video, is staying in your power. It doesn't mean you're more powerful than someone else or whatever. It's not a power struggle. It should never be a power. Nothing should ever be a competition or a power struggle. But it's about realizing that the power that you stand in is also the power that others like, that are torchbearers and, you know, wisdom holders. It's the same power they have, you know what I mean? That they're connected to. And it's about universal wisdom. It's about universal wisdom and knowing that one, you know, if someone has wisdom that's standing beside us, it doesn't mean they're more wise than us. It just means that we should be inspired to commit to the level of healing that, you know, someone else has in order to access that universal wisdom that they have. And there is nothing wrong with that. God, I feel like I'm transforming. I feel so strange. Shut up! Are you being sarcastic? We're all transforming every moment. Every moment. Okay. Okay, I don't know if that was for Virgo or not, but I had a hard time connecting with Virgo. So sorry if it didn't like resonate, but hopefully it resonated with someone. I might not even timestamp that. Timestamp that as Virgo. Okay, so for some reason, like, I almost said tame. Okay, so there's something about taming. Okay, yeah, there's something about, like, taming something or whatever, or someone thinking that, or believing that we should be, like, tame, or they should be tame, or whatever. You can connect to your, like, wild side, and it be okay. Like, it's okay to connect with that wild, like, you know, part of you. But it doesn't mean that you're a danger to anybody. Okay, it just means that you're connected to your most primal, like, natural, raw self. And sometimes that's hard to do, like, in this society, but it's getting easier because there's more and more awareness that's happening across the globe, thankfully. And, you know, there's a huge, like, veil that's being lifted that is revealing that it's okay to be connected to that because there's nothing shameful or bad or evil about it at all. Because we all, energy is never destroyed, only transformed. So, and with that in mind, a lot of energies and parts of us have been things that we maybe have been taught or held a belief that they were bad or evil, but they're not at all. You know, because we've all been through a level of a journey. Most of us here now, all aspects of us have been through a journey of upheaval and change, you know, because there's more than just one part of us. You're activating so much, not even close to kidding. That's awesome. Well, this is my gift of speaking and also perspective, and I've been greatly held back lately by, you know, I think that's like old beliefs and others and things like that, and that's why I'm speaking about it right now. It's taken a lot for me to even get onto these videos again because of it, but I'm not really at liberty or don't feel like really discussing it in detail at this moment. So if you're serious, then I'm glad because this is something that I'm here to do. Okay, 42 is joy. Joy is a high vibration. It is a high vibration. So, and you know, like, if you, this is for anybody watching the replay and you know, if you can find joy in things that others don't find joy in, then you know how to, you can transform anything. You know, like, laughing and humor is a great coping mechanism, actually. If you can find humor in things, you know, if you can laugh at things and not be offended or whatever, then, and if you can find, you know, things that are, that's so, so wise to do that. But it also speaks to the fact that, you know, you can take things lighthearted, even that are very heavy, and it can actually transform energy too, which is healing. Letting go. Okay, I don't tell many this, but I had a vision 7 years ago where Odin came down through the clouds and told me I was Thor, no lie. Then my family persecuted me and made me imprinted as being evil for it. Yeah, so we're talking about the same type of things here. We're talking about the same kind of things. Okay, and I'm going to touch base on this a little bit. This is what... maybe I will. Okay, so you know how people say, like, I was so-and-so in a past life, or... You know, I had a vision, or I know I was so-and-so in a past life or whatever. The thing is, like, to me, that's not really accurate at all because, okay, so for instance, my name is Dana. That is my ego in this life, okay? There will never be another Dana. There never was another Dana. Dana right now is the ego and the representation or the container of everything that is here right now in me, all right? So what that means is there's many aspects of us that either ascend or descend through time in this linear time that we're experiencing. And so what I'm saying is there's parts of us, there's parts of me that were here before that someone else maybe was healing or not healing. And so that doesn't mean that I was that person in a past life at all. Not even a little bit. So when I say, you know, I believe it's inaccurate. That's something that I've really come into like a deep understanding of lately, and I am going to teach about it more, because whenever someone, you know, you might have their, you know, you might connect and access memories that are, you know, someone else's life or past life, you know, but it doesn't necessarily mean that it doesn't mean at all that you were that person in a past life, but it does mean, you know, we have access also to the memory of others too, but also the memory of, you know, parts of us that were in someone else, if that makes sense. Okay, so like me as a human, like this is my ego, this is Dana, there will never be another Dana, you know, I won't be anyone in a past, in the next life, and I was no one in the past life, not me. these are parts of us that, you know, there's more than just one part of us. It's not just the soul. There's like spiritual parts of us. There's like your chakras, there's your mind, and there's your heart. You know what I mean? And those things are passed around and mixed up and stuff like that. And so right now I have the responsibility, for instance, of healing these parts of me that are here right now, or, you know, or not, or ignoring them. You know what I mean? And in our journey of wholeness, it's about like recognizing all parts of myself, not as like ownership of someone or even myself, someone in the past or even myself, but as with a remembrance of connectedness and oneness. So that way, next time, you know, if there is anything else that needs to be healed that I'm not healing, I have not healed in this life, that won't be me either. That's a part of someone else. That's not me. That they then have the responsibility of healing and recognizing and accepting. Make sense? Okay. So you may have been, you know, you may have parts of you that did belong to that, but maybe that is something to explore and discover, because it's very interesting. You know, like, it does make sense. I appreciate your perspective. You're welcome. Thank you for telling me that. Okay, so I do want to teach about that as well, because I have come into almost everything that I've learned is like from experience, and it's from like spiritually. It's not anything. Most of everything that I've learned is from my experiences and my connecting to my inner like wisdom or whatever. But it doesn't have to do with most of what I've learned. Like, it's hard to explain some of the stuff that I've learned and come into knowledge of, because a lot of it has not been actually. I have never read about it or anything, or saw it on anything. So I know that I am also pregnant with something, and I'm trying to get some clarity right. I'm coming into some clarity right now about it, so that I can know what to share and what not to share right now, because integrity is very important to me, and things that are beneficial to the whole and doesn't hurt anybody, because that is not my cause at all. There's like the opposite of my values and what I stand for. All right, self-love, 41. Okay, so again, here's the sun and the moon, you see? And then there's the heart, and the heart has wings. So to me, this has to do, and the water is just flowing down. So to me, this is gonna be the closing message, but this also has to do with duality and balance. You see how the heart is in the middle and it's got wings? Okay, that's allowing yourself to like open your heart up to give and to receive love, but to come to a level of self-love and holding love within you for yourself and everything that you are. And since love expands, it expands outwardly. And the more you come into self-love, the more that you hold love and expand it within you, the more beauty and love that you see and experience around you too. Because there, you know, and then that will bring you into balance. Okay? Because I believe that there's like a very also an accurate idea that self-love is in opposition to loving another. You know, some people believe that if you love yourself, you don't love others, but that's not true at all. Not even a little bit, because the self is like a representation of, it's a part of the whole, in my opinion. And since love expands, like, that's physics, okay? That's like, that's science, you know? Love really does expand, and I feel it too. And, you know, I'm very sensory oriented person. I would say it's a gift, but I don't know if I could call it that, to be honest. But no, if you grow in love and you start to be gentle with yourself and you look at yourself from a new perspective, as if you are, I like to say that a lot, it's an easier way to come into self-love, is looking at yourself as if you are your own child or something, okay? And that's looking at it from I can't think of the word, I tried to think of it earlier, but it's like a different point of view, different perspective. Then it'll be easier to look at yourself in a way that will help you cultivate self-love. And not only is that inspiring, but it's also expanding, and it's healthy and great if you have visions of universal love and oneness for the future, because it expands within you and around you. And the more I come into self-love, the more I come into love with myself, the more I get closer to that which I call God, and the more love and beauty and I experience around me, and the more that I love others too. Okay, and here's a swan, all right? So I see it as like, okay, so if you're not in self-love, then you see yourself as like an ugly duckling, you know? You see yourself as like, I don't deserve anything. Like, I'm just gonna give love to everybody else because that's what I need to do to myself for myself. So I just give it out instead. But once you start focusing on love and like looking at yourself in a different way so that you appreciate and value who you are today, you are essentially also valuing and loving others. And it does come out in actions too. Then that's whenever you're a swan. You recognize the swan that you are. Yeah. Okay. Thank you for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Yes, everything I'll put in the description box, and I love you guys. Pink light. Bye.